Welcome to BMC's Control and Managed File Transfer Enterprise B2B Overview video. In this video, you will learn about Control and Managed File Transfer Enterprise B2B and how to get started transferring and receiving files to and from your business partners. Organizations manage a significant amount of files from external business partners or external users. Security and ease of use are important factors in the management of these file transfers. Control-M MFT Enterprise B2B enables you to securely transfer and receive files on time to and from external users outside your organization. Control-M MFT Enterprise B2B includes all of the features of Control-M MFT. MFT Enterprise consists of three main components. The MFT Hub is the file transfer server that manages external file transfers. The MFT Gateway is installed in the DMZ and listens for incoming FTPS, SFTP, and HTTPS connections from external user accounts. These user accounts are defined in the MFT Hub. The MFT Gateway communicates with the hub, but does not store any file-related data. The MFT File Exchange is a web-based interface that allows external users to view the contents of their folders and upload and download files. Before you can transfer or receive files to and from external users, you need to set up a hub, create an external user, and create a virtual folder. Let's take a look at how you do this. First, we'll set up the hub. In the CCM, click the Manage tab, and then click the MFT B2B button. In the MFT B2B window, click Add Hub. To create the hub, you must fill in all five fields, so make sure that you have the information that you need. In the Select B2B Hub Environment field, select the Control-M agent where MFT is installed. In the Gateway Authentication Password field, enter the password used when you installed the MFT Enterprise B2B Gateway. In the Gateway Settings Domain Name field, enter the domain name for the machine that the gateway is installed on. This is where external users will connect to in order to transfer files. In the Site Settings Company Name field, enter your company name. This name will appear in the File Exchange website and also in the signature of the email notification that external users receive. And in the Company Support Email field, enter the email address of the contact in your company for external users. This enables external users to contact someone in your company if they have issues or questions. External users access this address in the File Exchange. Last, we'll click Create. After creating the hub settings appear. We can see that all the fields for the Gateway, Hub, and Site settings are filled in by default. Take note of the B2B subfolder name. You will need to use this when transferring files, which we'll see later in the video. Also, you can change any of the settings as needed, and then click Save. Now we'll create an external user. We'll click Users at the top of the window. In the Users tab, we'll click Plus to add an external user, and then fill in the relevant fields. The new user has been added. To see a list of users, you can search by company or user, or search using a wildcard to list all users. Next, we'll create a virtual folder. Let's click the Virtual Folders tab, and then click Plus to add a folder. Now we'll enter a name for the folder. As noted here, when you create a folder, by default, incoming and outgoing subfolders are created. Here you enter the size limit for the folder. Once this limit is reached, both internal and external users won't be able to upload files. In the retention time field, enter the number of hours that you want to keep files in the folder. You can also choose to automatically delete a file after it is downloaded from the incoming folder. If you want no limits on the size or retention time, then enter 0 in these two fields. In the Authorized External Users field, enter the usernames that you want to give access to the folder. Here you can choose to have an email notification that contains a link to the file and is sent to external users when a new file has been uploaded. Last, you can give folder access to specific internal users, or keep the default value for all users. And now we'll click Save to create the folder. Next, we'll take a look at how you transfer files to an external user. You transfer files to an external user the same way you transfer files internally in your organization. Make sure before you transfer files that you have created a connection profile to the hub using SFTP. In the control and planning domain, you create a file transfer job. Then you select the connection profile. First, we'll select the host where the file is located. In this video, it's localhost. And then you select the connection profile for the hub. For this video, B2B hub. Note that this connection profile was created using SFTP. Next, select the file that you want to transfer. We'll open the localhost and select a file. Now we'll open the hub side. We need to enter the B2B subfolder from the hub settings and then click Go. We can see the folders on the hub and the folder that we created, Company 1. We'll select Company 1 and then select Outgoing so that the file gets sent to the gateway. Now we'll order the job and check in the workspace. Next, we'll see how external users receive and download files on the MFT B2B File Exchange website. First, an external user receives an email notification that a file was transferred. Then the external user signs into the File Exchange website, entering the name and password that you created. As you can see, the external user doesn't need to search for the correct folder. The file that we transferred appears on the screen, and by default, the filter is set to all files, both files that were uploaded or files to be downloaded. The external user can download the file by selecting it and clicking Download. Next, let's take a look at how external users can transfer files to internal users. On the File Exchange website, after signing in, the external user clicks Upload File, locates the relevant file, selects the virtual folder, and clicks Upload. The file is automatically sent to the incoming subfolder on the Control-M MFT B2B hub. You can use the Watch option in a file transfer job to know when a file has been uploaded from an external user. You can also use the dashboard and search function to see external file transfers. One last note, the external user can use other methods to receive transferred files or upload files instead of using the MFT B2B File Exchange server, such as FTP over SSL, SFTP, or use REST API. Here's an example using SFTP to download a file. On the command line, you enter the external user's credentials, and then using standard SFTP commands, you can view your authorized folders and upload and download files. Thank you for watching this video. For more information about MFT Enterprise B2B, see the ControlM help.